Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this urban underground poster. I provided this grungy metal background for you to download. Its link is located in the video description or project files. In addition, I provided the link to the font I'll be using, as well as the scratches we'll be adding to the text. If you're not sure how to install fonts or custom brushes, watch my tutorials on how to do it. I provided the links to these tutorials as well. This document is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Bebas New. For the name of my main subject, I'll choose a size of 240 points, sharp, left alignment, and black for the color. Type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Keep in mind, feel free to design your poster. You can use as much or as little text as you like and position them anywhere you want. If your main subject has another line of text, make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Drag the copy to another area and press T on your keyboard to open your Type tool. Highlight the text and type out the second line. Open your Move tool to reposition it. Shift-click on the bottom text layer to highlight it and the other text layers. We'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Type in the name of your main subject and change its blend mode to overlay. To change its color, click on the adjustment layer icon and choose solid color. Pick a color you like and click OK or press Enter or Return. To clip the adjustment layer to effect just the text, press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Next, we'll add the secondary subject, which in this case is a date. Click off the eyeball of the folder to hide the main subject. We're doing this because its text takes up most of the document, which would make it difficult to type new lines of text. Open back up your Type tool and reduce its size. I'll choose 122 points and change the color to white. Type out your text. Now we can make the main subject visible again. Open your Move tool to reposition your secondary subject and change its blend mode to color dodge. Click on the FX icon and choose drop shadow. The blend mode is multiply. Make the opacity 55%, the distance 35 pixels, and the size 10 pixels. Then click OK. Hide your main subject again and make a copy of your secondary text. Drag the effects from the top copy to the trash since we won't be needing it. Reduce its point size. You can always change it later if you like. I'll make mine 60 points. Press Enter or Return to accept it. Change its color to black. Type out your text. Make your main subject visible again and move your text to a location you like. Make a copy of it and move it to another location. If you want to change its size, open your Type tool, highlight it, change its size, and accept it. Type out your new line of text. Open your Move tool to reposition it. Continue to add text using the same steps. To see all of your text layers, hover your cursor at the bottom of the panel, and when you see this vertical double arrow, drag it down. Let's place all the text into a folder, excluding your main subject. Shift-click on the bottom text layer and press Ctrl or Command-G. Name it whatever you like. Next, we'll add scratches and erosions to the text. Click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the folder. We'll add black scratches on the layer mask, which will reveal the background through them. Open your pencil tool and click on the arrow next to the brush size. Click on the gear icon, and if you downloaded and installed the brush set I provided, click Heavy Scratch Brushes by Doghouse. This free brush set was created by Doghouse Design Studio. Click OK to see just this set in the thumbnail window. Click on the gear icon and choose Large Thumbnail to see the brushes better. I'll choose this one, go near the center of my document, and left-click once. I'd like a bit more erosion on the date text, so I'll move my cursor all the way to the left and left-click. Let's add a translucent white scratch texture behind the black text to make them pop more. Make your background active and click on the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. Change its blend mode to soft light. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your thumbnails and pick a brush. I'll choose this one and reduce its size to 300 pixels. Click over the black text to make it stand out a bit more from the background. Don't be concerned if it's covering too much. We'll take care of that in a moment. Click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the translucent white texture. Press X to invert their foreground and background colors, and click over the areas of the white texture to hide them. To reduce the brush size, press the left bracket key. Continue clicking over the white texture until you've removed just enough. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.